Hey guys, Michael Kummer here. In today's video, I want to share with you 6 strategies that make fasting easier long term. So those are not quick fixes, but things you can implement to make fasting much, much easier and to make it a regular part of your health routine. Now, before we get started, a couple of things. One is I'm not a medical doctor, so nothing in this video should be considered medical advice. I might also have affiliate links in the video in the description that if you use those links, I might get a commission. Doesn't change the editorial integrity, but it helps make this channel happen. And the last thing I want to mention is that I have a lot of resources on the very subject on my blog. I'm going to link them down below. So check those out because they're gonna go into significantly more detail, have links to scientific research and rationale, and give you tips on how you can implement all of that. Many of the things I cannot cover as part of this video because I don't wanna make it an hour long. So check out the resources I'm gonna link down below for more information. And with that, we're gonna get started. So if you're new to fasting and you wonder, well, why would I wanna fast in the first place? You know, there are a couple of things that you wanna consider. Fasting has a lot of benefits, but there are also some issues, potential issues associated with it. From a benefit perspective, fasting can help you repair your gut by giving your digestive system a break. It makes you more metabolically flexible, improves your insulin sensitivity, very important, normalizes blood sugar levels, helps with autophagy, the cells or the body's cell recycle program that can also help with longevity and staying healthy, etc. It can help you lose weight. There are many, many benefits associated with intermittent fasting, and my wife and I have been doing it for many years with different schedules just based on how we feel and how it works for our current lifestyle. There are also a couple of issues associated with intermittent fasting. You definitely don't want to do it. You don't want to run into a chronic caloric deficit. That's not good, especially if you're a woman, that can cause hormonal issues. And you should also consider that fasting is a stressor. It's usually a positive stressor, but if you're already super stressed out, if you're sick maybe, if you're in overtraining, whatever, you don't want to add fasting on top of that. So be smart about it and use it wisely. And with that, we're going to talk about the 6 strategies you can use to make fasting much, much easier and a regular part of your routine. The first strategy, and arguably the most effective one, is to improve your metabolic flexibility. Metabolic flexibility means that your body can quickly switch between using different types of fuel for energy. And it's particularly important in the absence of food. So you might be using glucose as your primary source of fuel, and that's especially true if your diet is high in carbohydrates. If you're on a ketogenic diet, then you are likely using fat or ketones as your primary source of energy. And so when you are fasting, when you don't eat, then your body, the only fuel sources your body has is glycogen or glucose that's stored in glycogen, but that's fairly limited. You don't have much more than maybe 2000 calories. And when that runs out, then you feel crappy. Unless your body can also use its own fat for energy by burning body fat and turning it into ketones or fatty acids that you can use for energy. And so metabolic flexibility simply means that if you don't eat, your body can tap effectively and efficiently tap into your fat stores and use them for energy, so you feel less hungry and less crappy and less hangry. If you're not metabolically flexible, it's very difficult to fast. So one of the best strategies is to improve your metabolic flexibility by maybe going onto a ketogenic diet or a carnivore diet or something that's low in carbohydrates that forces your body to use fat for energy and it makes you metabolically flexible. Number 2 is focus on sleep quality. If you don't sleep well, your hormones in your body are off, and especially your ghrelin levels, that's the hunger hormone, might rise and you feel more hungry than otherwise. You might also try to make up for the lack of energy by eating energy dense foods. Again, makes you hungry. If you focus on sleep quality, if you sleep well every day, if you have a consistent sleep routine, it's significantly easier to fast than if you wake up and you're overly tired and fatigued. It's very difficult to fast in such a case. Number 3, limit your consumption of alcohol and cannabis because both drive up your appetite. And obviously, you cannot have alcohol while you're fasting because that would effectively break your fast. But even if you consume alcohol before starting your fast, maybe with the last meal that you had of the day, you might feel more hungry than if you didn't have alcohol. And also many people report when they smoke weed or consume cannabis in any shape or form, they get the munchies. They get hungrier than usual because those two substances influence your hunger hormone levels and potentially even your leptin levels, the hunger suppressing hormone, and that's not a good thing. So I usually recommend avoiding both alcohol and cannabis around your fasting time to make it much easier to fast for as long as you want to. Number four is to manage stress. Stress is another factor that can drive up your appetite and your body's desire to eat. And some of that is due to how we are wired from an evolutionary perspective. Stress back in the days typically meant you need to get energy to either fight or to run or to do something to preserve your life and to save your life. Now these days, our stressors are typically not life-threatening, at least not immediately. It might be financial bills, it might be parenting, it might be your work, whatever it is. But that also drives up hunger because your brain cannot really tell the difference between a situation that it was designed for, maybe, you know, running away from a saber-toothed tiger or something else, and your financial issues that you might have. So if you try to manage your stress, you can also manage your hunger and you will feel less hungry. Number five is watch out what you eat during your eating window. It matters very much what you eat before you start your fast or maybe after breaking your fast. If you have a diet that's high in carbohydrates, especially processed carbs, during your eating window, then it's gonna be significantly more difficult to fast because of your changing blood sugar levels. If you have carbohydrates, obviously, your blood sugar levels typically rise and then they fall. And depending on your metabolic health and other factors, they might sometimes even fall below normal levels and you feel incredibly hungry. And so I recommend to stick to a diet that's high in protein and fat, especially from animal-based sources, to maintain healthy blood sugar levels and to keep you satiated, so when you start your fast, you don't feel immediately hungry. Number six is to stay well hydrated, and that's because sometimes mild dehydration, your brain can actually mistake for hunger, and so if you're dehydrated, then you might experience that as hunger, even though it's just a dehydration. So if you stay well hydrated throughout the day, and I don't mean by that to overhydrate, there is such a thing as overhydrating, where you consume too many liquids, and it flushes out electrolytes and you run into an electrolyte imbalance, which can also make it more difficult to fast. But if you just maintain regular hydration levels and you get enough sodium in particular, maybe drink electrolytes or add some salt to your water, then it's much easier to fast than if you're not well hydrated. And with that, we're gonna wrap it up. Again, if you wanna have more information on that and how to mitigate and implement some of those strategies, check out the blog post that I'm gonna link down below in the description. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Until next time.